Hey YouTube, today I'm going to show you how you can downgrade any iOS 4.x to any other iOS 4.x. So basically, if you're trying to downgrade to any 4 point whatever, to whatever other 4 point whatever, this will work. So first, we're going to want to download your IPSW file you're trying to downgrade to. So let's say I'm trying to downgrade from 4.2.7 to 4.2.6. I'm going to want to download 4.2.6 because that's what I'm trying to downgrade to. So once you have downloaded your IPSW file, then you're going to want to put your device into DFU mode. All right, now for you guys to enter DFU mode, first what you're going to want to do is make sure your device is plugged into your computer. Hold down the power button to turn it off. So I'm just going to turn mine off. Now I'm not actually going to put mine into DFU mode, but I will show you guys a process. So then what you're going to want to do is hold down the sleep button and the home button for 10 seconds. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Now continue holding the home button, but release the sleep button for about 20. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, whatever. And just keep on holding the home button after the sleep and home button at the same time. Just continue holding this until your device recognizes it as a USB device. And once that has, then you can go ahead and let go. Then your device will be in DFU mode, and then you're going to want to do the next step. Okay, guys, once your device is in DFU mode, then we're going to want to edit one of the iTunes files so that we can successfully downgrade our iDevice. So then go ahead and click on the Start button. Make sure you're in the search box and type in Notepad. Right click on the Notepad application and click Run as Administrator. Yes. And once it is opened up, go ahead and click File, Open. And then go into the C drive, Windows, System 32. Drivers, etc. Now, if there are no documents in here, then go ahead and change this little box right here to All Files, and then open up Hosts. Now, if there are any gs.apple.com addresses at the bottom of the screen, go ahead and delete all of those, including their little number signs if they have any of them. And then once you are on the bottom of the last line, go ahead and click Enter, and then paste this address in the very bottom, which will be in the description below. I don't expect you guys to actually memorize that. So basically, it should look similar to mine. It should just have a bunch of information, and then only one address at the bottom with gs.apple.com at the end, and that should only be this one right here. So once you guys have changed that, go ahead and click File and Save. And just keep it open because we're going to have to edit this later on. Now, if you guys are on a Mac, it's going to be a whole different process, which will be in the link description below, which I'm not going to show you guys because I'm not on a Mac. So, once you have edited that, go ahead and minimize Notepad and make sure your device is in DFU mode, it is plugged in, and that you have your IPSW file already downloaded. So, once iTunes opens up and you're in your device screen, go ahead and make sure your stuff is backed up and synced. So make sure before you do this, in case something goes wrong, you transfer purchases and you back up. Now once you guys have done that, go ahead and hold down Shift if you're on Windows, or if you're on a Mac, go ahead and hold down Alt or the Options key and click Restore. So I'm just going to demonstrate how to do it. I'm going to hold down Shift and click Restore. Now this screen will pop up. And go ahead and find your IPSW file. If you don't know where it is, go ahead and try to find it. And then select it and click Open. It's going to ask you, do you want to restore? It will erase all your stuff and restore to your iDevice to whatever iOS. You're going to want to click Restore. Now, I'm not actually going to show you guys how to... I'm not actually going to do this, but I'm just going to show you guys how to. So, then you're going to want to click Restore, like I just said, but I'm going to click Cancel. So, once your device is restoring... it should give you an error. Now, if it doesn't give you an error, then you're lucky and you didn't get an error, but your device should be downgraded. But if you did get an error, which most people should, go ahead and download RecBoot, which will be in the description below. And once you have downloaded RecBoot, it will be a zip file, so go ahead and right-click on that and click Extract Files. And once you have extracted the files, go ahead and go back into go into the RecBoot that has been extracted, go into the RecBoot folder, go into the RecBoot application, and hit Exit Recover Mode. Now that is only, I repeat, only if you got an error during the downgrading, but if you did not get an error, then this is not required. But go ahead and click Exit Recovery Mode, and once you have clicked on that, then your device should be out of recovery mode, and your device should be restored to the iOS you told it to. But before you're done, go ahead and go back to the notepad that we did not close out of, and then go ahead and delete that last gs.apple.com IP address. Now you should have no gs.apple.com addresses. That's fine. iTunes should automatically fix that afterwards. So then go ahead and close out of it and click Save. So that, guys, that is just so that in future you can update other firmwares without there being problems. Alright guys, that's just how you can downgrade any iOS 4.x to any other 4.x firmware. And if you guys had any issues with this at all, go ahead and comment in the video section below, in the comment section below, or go ahead and message me. I will definitely try to help you guys out with any problems you have, or any kind of problems with downgrading or restoring. So yeah, guys, this is how you downgrade any iOS 4.x to any other 4.x software. Like I said, if you have any problems, go ahead and message me or comment. Remember to like, subscribe, and comment. And I'll see you guys later.